Hi, Travis from pos-x.com. Today we're doing a quick video on how to set up your barcode scanner. A barcode scanner is an input device that emulates a keyboard. It's really easy to set up. So you take your scanner out of the box, and most manufacturers will have either the cable plugged in or the cable in the box. USB is the most common interface. It works for pretty much 99% of all the people out there. Plug in your cable, you'll hear a click where the little retention clip will lock in, and then you take the other end of your USB cable and you plug it into your USB port. Your computer can be on, you don't have to turn it off, you just turn it on and you let Windows find it. It'll say, usually say in the bottom corner here, it'll say detecting either the brand of your scanner, so say like a Zebra barcode scanner or Honeywell barcode scanner, or it'll say human interface device or HID device. Once it's installed, you'll see a beam come out for it, and then you're ready to scan. So where it scans to is wherever the cursor is. So opening up Notepad, so the cursor is in the bottom there, and I'll just scan, and that's where it scans to. One other thing you may need to do is to set a carriage return on the scanner if you want it to set a carriage return automatically. In the box is normally a quick start guide. If your scanner doesn't come with a quick start guide, you can download it off of our website. And one of the first barcodes you're going to see is add an enter key or add a carriage return or add a line feed. You just scan the barcode for that. And now when you scan, it'll add the enter key automatically after you're done. If you rather send a tab key instead of a carriage return at the end of your scan, all you have to do is find the barcode in the quick start manual for add a tab key. You scan that. And now it'll automatically remove the carriage return and send the tab key instead. So it scanned and then tabbed over. If you want to go back to the carriage return, then you scan the barcode for a carriage return. Also, if you scan any other configuration codes, like if you accidentally scan the serial barcode or a country code or some kind of speed emulation, and you're no longer able to scan where the cursor is, there's a return to defaults barcode. Scanning that, restore it to how it is when you're out of the box, and then when you scan, it'll be just like you took it out of the box. In this case, no carriage return or anything gets sent. You just scan the carriage return one more time, and now once again you are sending carriage returns. So that's really all there is to setting up a barcode scanner. It's not a complicated process for the most part. You plug it in, you're ready to go. Add a carriage return if that's what you want to do. For more information on setting up your scanner or to download a manual for your barcode scanner, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.